Question 1. Which of the following is most effective mode of teaching learning? 1. Rote memorization of content. 2. Exploration of relationships between concepts. 3. Observation without analysis. 4. Imitation and repetition. Answer 2. Exploration of relationships between concepts. Question 2. A teacher should analyze the various errors made by students on a given task because 1. She can decide degree of punishment accordingly. 2. Understanding of errors are meaningful in the teaching learning process. 3. She can segregate those who made more errors in comparison to others. 4. Learning is solely based on correction of errors. Answer 2. Understanding of errors are meaningful in the teaching learning process. Question 3. It is difficult for children to learn when 1. Information is presented in disconnected chunks. 2. They are intrinsically motivated. 3. Learning is socially contextualized. 4. Content is represented through multiple ways. Answer 1. Information is presented in disconnected chunks. Question 4. Best state of learning is 1. High arousal, high fear. 2. Low arousal, high fear. 3. Moderate arousal, no fear. 4. No arousal, no fear. Answer 3. Moderate arousal, no fear. Question 5. Constructivist view of learning suggests that children dash construction of their own knowledge. 1. Have no role to play in. 2. Are solely dependent on adults for. 3. Play an active role in. 4. Are solely dependent on textbooks in. Answer 3. Play an active role in. Question 6. Which of the following belief is good for learning? 1. Ability is improvable. 2. Ability is fixed. 3. Efforts don't make any difference. 4. Failure is uncontrollable. Answer 1. Ability is improvable. Question 7. Conceptual understanding among students is likely to improve in the settings which emphasize on 1. Competition. 2. Textbook-centric pedagogy. 3. Frequent examinations. 4. Inquiry and dialogue. Answer 4. Inquiry and dialogue. Question 8. During a task, Saina is talking to herself about ways she can proceed on the task. According to Lev Vygotsky's ideas on language and thought, this kind of private speech is a sign of 1. Cognitive immaturity. 2. Self-regulation. 3. Egocentrism. 4. Psychological disorder. Answer 2. Self-regulation. Question 9. Evaluation practices should aim at 1. Labeling of students. 2. Segregation of students for ability-based groups. 3. identifying students' needs and requirements. Fourth, identification of high achievers for prize distribution. Answer 3. Identifying students' needs and requirements. Question 10th. Individual differences in development of children can be attributed to 1. Heredity only, 2. Environment only, 3. Neither heredity nor environment, 4. Interplay of heredity and environment. Answer 4. Interplay of heredity and environment.